Let's move on to the third talk of this session. Speaker is Mohammed Sabir.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are audible. Time is 15 minutes, so 12 minutes talk and 3 minutes for discussion, please.
Okay. So can I share my screen now?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. So I'm having a hard time to show my this Zoom picture to hide this.
Mohammed, you're visible and so is your presentation. You just need to go to
slide
one. Yeah,
but it's covering my picture here. So the Zoom picture is overlapping with the PDF.
It's okay. You are visible. Just go to slide one and start.
Okay. So actually, I might not be able to look through my own slides. I have to make it go away.
There would be a minimize screen option besides your image.
Yeah. So yeah, so my talk is about the when black holes demands a new Lie algebra. So as you can see, my talk is going to be parallel both in physics and maths. So I have to describe both of them, and it's going to be hard for me to squeeze through a 15-minute window, but I'll try my best. So let's start. So moral of the story is here. So the first of my plans. So I'll start with the moral of the story, then I describe the physics side of story. Then the math side story, this should have been the math side of story, sorry. And the marriage of two sides, then we describe our work and some results from there, like vector model of forms. So our work like falls in the category where we suggest some new insights in math. And in the following flow chart, we can debrief in a little bit here. So for physics side, we talk about quarter BBS black holes in N-square force symmetry, and where we are interested in CHL models based on Zn or B-folds. So there are two ingredients, the partition function and walls of margin stability. While on the other hand, math point of view, so we talk about BKM Lie superalgebras and beyond. So this is the work where we are trying to find out things. And this means there will be like a Bochian extension of some rank 3 hyperbolic algebras for N-square 2, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and some more general extension of wave finites, where we will be talking about. And there we will find some WKB means Weierstrass Bochian denominator identities and walls of Weyl chamber and relation between them. So let's start with the physics side of story. So here we start with the N-square 4 string theory in 4 dimension means 16 superchargers. So we are interested in CHL models based on these N or B-folds. And this number, so the values of N restricts up to 8 due to Mukai because of symplectic automorphism of orbifold action. So begin with the heterodic string theory on 4 is equal to 4 torus. and two circles S1, S1 with period 2 pi. So take the orbit fold by a Zn group generated by 2 pi by n shift along S1. Also in order in left moving to symmetry of T4 cross S1 head counterfactual string. So this render n is good for supersymmetry preserved, but number of massless vector multiplied change to this number given by 48 by n plus or minus 2. So there is a dual picture here. So begin with the type 2 string theories on K3 S1 cross S1 head. Take the orbit fold by a Zn group generated by 2 pi by n shift along with S1 and also in order and symmetry of the internal CFT of K3, preserving its control supersymmetry. So let's focus on when n being a prime number, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. So though the result has been also generalized for n being composite. So the number of even gauge fields in these theories is Pn plus 6, the states are characterized by electric magnetic charge vectors Q and Qm of dimension Pn plus 6. So we have here moduli fields. There are 6 n plus 2 of them, scalar fields in S4 string theories. And set of matrix valued scalar fields M satisfying this relation, where L being the signature matrix of this size. And there are also an axiom relative field, lambda. So let's talk about the dual symmetries. So T-duality, each of charge vector Q and Qm transforms under a T-duality group, this group, which preserves the charge lattice, which is an even separable lattice of signature A. And the T-duality invariants are here, these guys. And let's talk about S-duality. So a dynamic charge vector Q and Qm in this story and S modulus axiom relative field, lambda, both transform under congruent subgroup of SL2Z such that these A, B, C, D belongs to a gamma 1 type congruent subgroup. And now the walls of margin stability. So far away from the black hole, the vacuum is parameterized by arbitrary values of these moduloid fields, M infinity and lambda infinity. So wherever infinity shows means we are far away from the black holes. So as we move in this asymptotic modulized space, we encounter a codimension one subspace called also margin stability. So a quarter BPS state can decay into two half BPS states as one moves across the wall of margin stability. So here we get the equation of circle, which represents these arcs in the upper half plane, where E depends on all the moduli fields, ABCD and charge. It does not depend on the lambda infinity. So the arc intersects the real lambda infinity axis at A over C and B over D for a given E. When E scale is zero, the arcs are semi-circles centered on the real lambda infinity axis with radius 1 over 2CD. So when either of C or D are zero, the circles become straight lines according to the real axis for E scale is zero. So these are some examples for n is equal to 1, 2, and 3. And for n more greater than 3, there are some like infinity arcs reaching up to limiting points. So now we count the BPS states. So in these theories, the number of microscopic quantum states for black hole is determined by degeneracy of quarter BPS states. So quarter BPS states are generated by the genus to Siegel model forms, phi kn, where k depends on n. And k is also the weight of label n subgroup of sp2z. So one has this relation, the generating function for the degeneracies, where z belongs to Siegel upper half space of genus 2, where Siegel upper half plane is defined by these relations. So z belongs to complex numbers, and tau and omega are the upper half plane numbers, and this relation is there. And we are making following identifications. And the triplet NLM is simply defined by these numbers. And this greater than zero means these conditions follow, where the weight function for prime values is given by this. And this has been shown in work of De Graaf, Verlinde brothers, Jart and Sain. While for the composite value of n for 4 and 6, this has been shown by Suresh Govindarajan and his former students. So now we discuss about the math side of the story. So here we talk about the SL2Z, which is like mother of all Lie algebras, and we complexify it. And we have the generators in terms of Pauli's matrices. They have their relations. Now we take multiple copies of SL2Z and try to construct a new Lie algebra with these following relations called Chevalier relations. So here, any AIG can be taken as an element of the matrix, which we call in general Cartan matrix. So algebra G tilde is spanned by multiple commutators. So as you can see, there is no upper limit for this size of these commutators. So far, there is no relation among EI and FI. So this doesn't truncate the size. So, but we got a theorem due to Kaas that there always exists a unique maximal subalgebra I, which has Lie brackets closed with G tilde. This means we can always quotient out I from G tilde. So we get a smaller Lie algebra, may not be the finite always, but we get a small Lie algebra. And putting the generators of I equal to zero gives you the set relations. So now we classify our Lie algebra into a Kaas-Moody Lie algebra. So the algebra G may be GA, may be finite or infinite dimensional, depends on the off diagonal entries of the Cartan matrix. So if we restrict off diagonal entries of matrix A to be non-positive integers only, the algebra G is said to be Kaas-Moody algebra. So here you can see the following chart. So we are interested in these three cases, the finite dimensional, affine, and hyperbolic cases. So when determinant, when the matrix A is non-singular, we always got finite dimensional. Otherwise, there is an infinite dimensional algebra. And if the eigenvalue is zero, we get affine. And there is a special case for other, that if the signature of the matrix is Lorentzian type. So we also may get the hyperbolic Lie algebra. If removing one, any one of the row or column of same index, will get you the finite or affine. So now we come to the Bortius Lie algebra. So by allowing the diagonal entries, AII, of matrix A, not just two, but also non-positive real numbers, we get a bigger class of Lie algebra for Bortius class of Lie algebras. Now we can associate to every Lie algebra a root lattice. A lattice Q of rank R equipped with a bilinear form. For finite case, it is just a Killing form. So it's called the root lattice of algebra G. If it has bases like alpha 1 up to alpha R, so that the Gram matrix induced by alpha I represents the Cartan matrix such that in this form. So now the Weyl group. So if the pairing between alpha I is 2, then alpha I also called the real simple root. The reflection of any lambda, any vector belongs to Q with respect to real simple roots, alpha I is given by lambda minus the twice of the component in that direction, or simply this formula called a simple reflection, and a group generated by all the simple reflections is called the Weyl group. So now roots. So any elements of the Weyl orbit of real simple roots.
So
when it's exhausted by all the Weyl orbit, every simple roots give the full sets of roots. And for every root alpha, there is minus alpha also a root, and alpha is equal to zero not being a root means we can always partition into two disjoint sets. So one is called the positive roots and other one is the negative roots. And further, we can decompose the Lie algebra into triangular way. And dimension of all these G alphas is called the multiplicity of alpha. So now we define the Weyl denominator formula for this guy. So this is the product side, this is the sum side. where rho is the wild vector defined by this guy and Grishenko's convention. So for example, let's start with SU3. So Cartan matrix is given by these guys, and we have, let's say alpha 1, alpha 2 are the simple groups. So we have the wild group, which is exactly the S3 symmetric group, and full set of roots are given by these. We have the multiplicities, every roots have multiplicity 1 here, and we get the denominator formula here like this. And when determinant is singular, means we have a finite algebra. So we talk about the SU2 case, where Cartan matrix is given by these, and these are the simple roots, and these wild group, the full set of roots, and we also have a non-imaginary root, which have non-zero, and here also the root multiplicity are one. So by identifying these values with the Q and R, we get the product side in this form, and here is the sum side. So this gives you the famous Jacobi triple product diagram. And if we extended our formula for Borchardt's case, we got an extra convection term T here, and which depends on the pairwise orthogonal simple imaginaries. So let's talk about an example here.
So we don't have time. You can take 1 minute to wind up.
So let me skip these guys here. So we can show an example for how T correction term here.
Please show your results. Please skip all these things. Get to your results.
Okay.
The last, on the.
So let's talk about
the vector valued model forms. That's all. Go to that.
I'm still having the overlap of my zoom over my slides. It's hard. Can someone help me through here?
It says partition function, slide number I can't see.
Okay, so.
Marriage of the sides. You're coming to embedding. Keep going.
So here we talk about the partition function. So Seeger modulo forms the square roots of yn. We talk about the square roots of pi n here, which have integral Fourier coefficients up to n is equal to 6. And up to n of the 4, for each one of them has found to be the product set of a WKB denominator formula of some Borchardt extension of an algebra respectively. And this part shouldn't be here. And for delta kn corresponding to different order of pointing is still some Borchardt extension of an, except the correction term t is different now. The multiplicative seed for these four Seeger models are of 0 Jacobi forms, size 0 n, which are the elliptic genera of Calabi and Mansfield for disks 2, 3, 4, and 8, respectively. The Jacobi forms are associated with pure ANML root system in their AD classification, and there we get an other weight 0 Jacobi forms, size 0, 6, that can be associated to n is equal to 6 case. And the walls of margin stability. The walls of margin stability for instance, 1, 2, 3 are literally the walls of wild chambers associated to the BKMD algebra, AN. We also have the walls of wild chambers associated to A5 and A6. And a no-go theorem due to Grishenko and Nikolin says only an algebra more general than BKM may relate to the partition functions for n 5, 6 as the denominator formula. This is the work we are trying to do, find that generalized version of Lie algebra. So our side of the story. So we're trying to decompose problem into the, we know that into those metrics, there is a diagonal blocks of SL2 Lie algebras. So we're trying to decompose this problem into the characters of SL2 head. Since the characters of Lie algebra remain invariant under associated wild group, we may try to decompose these Seeger model forms in terms of the characters of SL2 head. So, like here we can, so here's the Fourier Jacobi expansion for this guy. As you can see, this is the multiplicative sheet for this guy. So the character is defined in this way, where theta KLs are the generalized theta function. We decompose psi 0 n for n is equal to 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 6, like this. And we computed G1 tau and G2 tau and others as a Q series. For example, here you can see these. We got them up to pretty much high orders. And psi 04, there's a special case. We got constants instead of Q series. And there are other decompositions like this. So on the way to the finding new algebra, we ended up finding some nice examples of vector valued model of forms. So these G1s, G2, and
sorry, Shubhriya, may I humbly request that one may keep track of the time, please?
Yes.
Time is we have these vector model forms. They fit through nice the definition given by Gannon.
Time is over.
Yes. Thanks. So these are the results and some. This is summary. We study single model forms that are constructed from umbral Jacobi forms as the Weierstrass bodges denote formulas. We first show that all the superalgebra admits the SL2 head subalgebras. We then study the decomposition of single model forms in terms of SL characters. The first non-trivial terms lead to the decomposition of the umbral Jacobi forms in terms of SL characters. This decomposition provides a vector valued model of forms for each case. We obtain closed formulas for all these vector valued model of forms in particular. We show that all but one of them are sufficient to the model matrix differential equation studied by Gannon. These formulae provide the multiplicity of real and imaginary simple groups of the algebra and the future direction. So our next goal is to obtain SL2 decomposition for full single model of forms. And also we have started to look into single model forms for the CHL order forms. Thank you.
Thank you, Sabir. I think we are running short of time.